the drivers decided to go on strike, because the drivers were saying that if we have already done our test at Kenya or Tanzania or any other entry point, then why would, at the exit point, then why would we do it again at the entry point? And obviously, the test for the COVID is also very high.
The escalating fuel crisis, which started almost 2 weeks ago, is still here. Even petrol stations in Kampala, whose prices had remained at 4,990 per litre for the last 1 week, have shot to 5,000 shillings and above. The chairperson of the Uganda Petroleum Dealers Association, Dr. Rajni Taylor, says the current fuel scarcity in the country is going to take 2 more weeks to normalize, despite steps taken to clear the backlog of trucks at the border.
Because of their strike, the government had no choice at all but to allow the drivers to come in. Now, within that shortage, because as far as I'm concerned, I don't think that the reserves of the fuel are there in the tankers, because the facility of the bond is not being allowed anymore by the Uganda Revenue Authority and the concern authority. And therefore, I appeal to the government that the bond facilities should be allowed so enough fuel can be stored in the reserve tanks.
Uganda consumes 1.6 million liters of fuel per day.
The dealers themselves are causing these shortages. That I do not agree at all, because first and foremost, there is a money curse. So I don't see anyone holding the fuel of such a nature, because each truck of the fuel carries from 6,000 to 12,000 liters. And there is no way you can hold it because you want to increase your price. You cannot afford it at this time of business. So I still don't agree with that some people are holding the fuel. That is not true.
Dr. Taylor has supported the proposal by the Prime Minister, Robin Anabanja, to boycott petrol stations that have hiked their prices beyond 5,000 shillings, saying the available supply of fuel can't cushion the aggregate demand.
The Prime Minister, if any person selling the fuel over 5,000 shillings, there should be totally banned buying fuel from them, and they will learn a lesson. Because most of my friends have called me that, Mr. Taylor, there shouldn't be any problem because we have enough fuels.
However, the Uganda Petroleum Dealers Association says if government does not revamp its fuel reserves across the country, cases of fuel shortages will keep hurting the economy.
We do not have this reserve, and we only depend what the trucks deliver and you sell it. Then I think the crisis, if it happens again, the situation may not be good for it. Now, this is not the first time we are going into this crisis. It has even happened before in terms of the strike on the other side of it, in terms of the truck drivers, and there are other things which causes a lot of problems. So my humble appeal to the government and the revenue authority to is better to allow the fuel in the bond facility.
Prime Minister Robin Anabanja this week directed the Ministry of Energy to invoke the Energy Supply Act to sanction petrol stations that are creating an artificial scarcity to charge exorbitant prices. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.